नमस्कार दोस्तों, 83 फाइनली रिलीज हो चुकी है एंड आई वाज एक्साइटेड टू सी दिस मूवी फॉर टू मेन रीजंस। रीजन वन इज द मूवी इटसेल्फ। हम सब इस मूवी का काफी टाइम से वेट कर रहे। रीजन टू वाज दैट आई वाज गोइंग टू सी अ मूवी इन अ थिएटर आफ्टर ऑलमोस्ट 2 ईयर्स, सो आई वाज लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड टू दिस एक्सपीरियंस। पता चला कि नंदू अभी भी धूम्रपान करता है, और फिर कुछ एक डजन एड्स के बाद मूवी शुरू हो गई। सो लेट मी सेट द रिकॉर्ड स्ट्रेट ऑन वन थिंग अबाउट दिस मूवी गाइस। Now, although you can see that there is a sincere attempt to give equal screen time and equal focus on all our players, but by the end of the movie, you will figure out that this is essentially Kapil Dev's World Cup story. Yes, no doubt that each and every player get their moment to shine, but when you take out the reality factor and see this just as a movie, you see that Kapil Dev is essentially Kabir Khan of Chak De India. Like how in that movie, each and every hockey player gets good screen time and has a story of their own, but ultimately it's Kabir Khan's story of redemption. And here it's Kapil Dev who has to manage and captain an underdog team, which almost everyone believes will not proceed beyond the group stage in the World Cup. Of course, unlike in Chak De, there is no 70-minute wala speech here. On the contrary, there is a funny sequence where the team manager asks Kapil Dev to give an inspiring speech to his teammates, and the way Kapil delivers that speech and his teammates react to it is quite hilarious. In another sequence, we see the West Indian cricket team being welcomed like rock stars, while Team India is standing on the sidelines waiting for their team bus to arrive. The Team India were absolute underdogs, so much that the cricket board had booked the return tickets of the players that was dated even before the semi-final match. We see that the players are so underpaid that they even do their own laundry. And even when India wins 2 matches in a row, the English media dismisses it as a fluke. And then you also feel a sense of pride when you realize that today India is ruling world cricket when it comes to getting sponsors and viewerships. The popularity of this sport only started growing with the 1983 World Cup victory. So in a way, this movie is like a perfect origin story for Indian cricket. Just imagine guys, before 1983, India ne sirf ek World Cup match jeeta tha, and that too against East Africa. And none of our players had ever scored a century in an ODI match. सेंचुरी से याद आया, विराट कोहली सेंचुरी इज ड्यू फ्रॉम अ लॉन्ग टाइम नाउ। क्या आपको लगता है कि इंडिया साउथ अफ्रीका सीरीज में वो सेंचुरी स्कोर करेगा? मुझे तो लगता है वो डेफिनेटली स्कोर करेगा। तो मैं प्रोबो ऐप पे जाके इस सवाल पे यस बिड करूंगा, और अगर आप भी अपने ओपिनियंस को लेकर काफी कॉन्फिडेंट है तो प्रोबो ऐप पे जाइए, अपने ओपिनियंस को बिड कीजिए और पैसे कमाए। Like for example, मुझे लगता है कि assuming India will be leading 1-0 or 2-0 after the second test, Panchal might get a chance to play in the third test, so I will place my bid accordingly. और भी ऐसे कई सवाल हैं जिन पर आप bid कर सकते हैं, जैसे कि क्या आपको लगता है कि first test के openers Mayank और Rahul रहेंगे? चलो हम 83 के बारे में बात कर ही रहे हैं, तो क्या आपको लगता है कि 83 मूवी बॉक्स ऑफिस पर पहले हफ्ते में 120 करोड़ से ज्यादा कमाई कर सकती है? तो अपने ओपिनियंस को बिड करने के लिए प्रोबो ऐप को डाउनलोड करें, एंड प्लीज डाउनलोड इट फ्रॉम द लिंक इन माय वीडियो डिस्क्रिप्शन। नाउ कमिंग बैक टू द रिव्यू, हैट्स ऑफ टू द एंटायर कास्ट एंड क्रू फॉर गेटिंग द क्रिकेट सीन्स एब्सोल्युटली स्पॉट ऑन। नाउ नॉट ओनली डिड दे मेक द बैटिंग एंड बॉलिंग लुक कन्विंसिंग, दे इवन सक्सेसफुली मैनेज टू रेप्लिकेट द डिसमिसल्स एक्जैक्टली द वे इट हैपेंड इन रियल। एंड इवन दो देयर इज सम वीएफएक्स इन्वॉल्वड, इट्स रियली नॉट एज इजी एज इट सीम्स टू एग्जीक्यूट इट। Did you know that the legendary Sunil Gavaskar scored only 59 runs in the 6 matches that he played in the World Cup? Well, these stats are not exactly highlighted in the movie, but you can sense it in a couple of scenes how this lack of form was really affecting his confidence, and it was kind of brave from the writers to even bring it up in the movie. Now, when we talk about the 1983 World Cup in general, the first image that comes to our mind is that of the final match between India and West Indies. You know, the celebration, Kapil Dev holding the World Cup trophy. Barely anyone talks about India's first match of the World Cup at Manchester, where we had already defeated West Indies once. Did you know that in this match, in the Indian innings, 9 boundaries were scored, and all of these boundaries came from Yashpal Sharma? And here's a more interesting stat. In the West Indies innings, there was just 1 6 and not a single 4. We are talking about a West Indies team that was in prime form and were the favorites to win this title. And this says a lot about the quality of our bowling attack in this match. And I'll be honest here, yes, the final match between India and West Indies was picturized very well, but I really enjoyed the India-Zimbabwe match more, simply because of the fact that we never got to see Kapil Sir's 175 on screen or anywhere else. On the match day, BBC was on strike, and so it was not broadcasted on television. At least we have the luxury of watching that record-breaking innings being recreated on big screen. If there has to be just one sole reason to watch this movie on big screen, it is this 175 not out innings from Kapil Dev. And I loved the little touches that the director gave here, like after breaking the world record for highest number of runs The crowd starts clapping and applauding Kapil Dev, but Kapil appears confused on why the crowd has suddenly started cheering for him after he takes a single. The final winning moment, where the whole of India appeals together in one voice for the LBW decision, has been captured quite dramatically, but it was effective, I guess, because I could see people in my screen joining in this moment of madness as well. The movie smartly keeps cutting to real photos from the World Cup, which lends more authenticity to the proceedings. Now, everything's not perfect here. Like, once again, just like any other Indian movie on cricket, the commentary part is very ordinary. Thankfully, I was able to ignore it because of the on-field action. The background score is consistently effective, but one of the songs starts playing out of nowhere when an India-Australia match is going on. Also, I like the way they portrayed the West Indian cricket team with respect. The issue was with the way the crowd was portrayed. In India-England match, we see unruly behavior from the English crowd. Then again in the final match, we see the same kind of behavior from the West Indian crowd. That was not required at all. Each and every actor has played their part really well. Ranveer Singh is no doubt the heart and soul of the movie. And it is to the actor's credit that we never see the trademark Ranveer Singh mannerisms even once in the movie, as the actor completely immerses himself in the role of Kapil Dev. Pankaj Tripathi is an actor par excellence, and he plays the role of Team India's manager PR Mansingh with ease and great conviction. Among the other actors, I like Jeeva as Krishnamachari Srikant and Jatin Sarna as Yashpal Sharma. And look, no offense to the actor and the cricketer, but Tahir Singh Basin looked more like Sanjay Mandrekar rather than Sunil Gavaskar. Overall guys, watch this movie with your friends and family. It doesn't really matter if you're a cricket fan or not. The adrenaline rush and emotions come by automatically as you watch the cricket scenes. And for non-cricketing portions, there is still enough content to keep you entertained. Let me know what you think about my review in the comment section. Like, comment and subscribe if you haven't already. Don't forget to download the Probo app from the link in the description below. And please don't forget to press the bell icon to get notification of my new uploads. You can also follow me on my social media handles, which is again mentioned in the video description below.